Welcome to our FLOWgate tutorial series. This video will explain what the session browser is, how to use it, how to import and export sessions, and how to organize your sessions. A session incorporates activities related to controlling, monitoring, data collection, and configuration of a FLOWSIC device with the help of the FLOWgate software. During a session in the FLOWgate program, the software automatically logs all major operations. These logs are later available for offline reading and analysis. When you start a new connection to a device, the software will generate a new session in the session browser. If you switch between online and offline mode, the software will register a new session and create a new session in the list. The session browser can be opened from the device navigation menu by selecting Session Browser. Once opened, a list of sessions logged for the connected device is displayed on the left-hand side of the screen. When you click on a session, the program will display the session details in a list on the right-hand side of the screen. Depending on the session entry type, several actions may be available, such as data record playback and report creation from parameter sets. To import a FLOWgate session, first click Import on the session toolbar. Next, click the folder icon to select the session file from the file system. Then click OK to start the import process. If the session file contains unit system details, a Replace Unit Settings dialog will appear. Select whether you want to use the current unit system settings in FLOWgate or the unit settings in the imported file for the current device. Confirm the import by clicking OK. Clicking Cancel will stop the entire import process. Otherwise, the imported session with all its entries will be added to the list of sessions at the end of the import process. Session data can also be exported. To do this, click the Export button in the Sessions toolbar. Here, you have the option to change the file name and select a folder where the exported session files should be stored. Next, select whether the session file should contain unit display settings, data records, and reports. Unselecting these features can reduce the file size of the session export file. Exporting the current active session will stop the session and start a new one. By default, sessions are named using the session starting timestamp. To improve the readability of the session list and simplify the search for particular sessions, session entries can be renamed. To do this, select a session in the sessions list, go to the toolbar, and click Rename. In the subsequent dialog, enter a new name for your session and confirm by clicking OK. If a session is no longer required, you can remove it using the Delete button. Select the session in the Sessions list and click Delete. Confirm the removal of the session by clicking OK. Note that it is often prudent to export a session prior to removing it. To find a particular session entry, such as a recording, it can be useful to filter the list of sessions to only display sessions with a desired entry type. To do this, use the Session Entries filter. By clicking on a particular session entry type, you can filter the list of sessions according to whether the entry type is turned on or off.